Good morning. We will start with the four-stroke compression ignition engine. Four-stroke compression ignition engine. The four-stroke compression ignition engine is similar to four-stroke spark ignition engine, but it operates at a much higher compression ratio. The compression ratio in case of spark ignition engine is between 6 to 10, while in case of compression ignition engine it is between 16 to 20. In the CI engine, during suction stroke, air instead of fuel air mixture is induced. Okay, only air will be induced. Due to higher compression ratios employed, the temperature at the end of compression stroke is sufficiently high to self ignite the fuel, because compression ratio in case of compression this CI engine is very high, so the fuel will automatically burn without any spark. The carburetor and ignition system is not required in case of SI engine. So we will start with the first with the strokes are same as in SI: suction stroke, compression stroke, expansion stroke, exhaust stroke. So in suction stroke, air alone is induced during the suction stroke. Inlet valve is open, exhaust valve is closed. During compression stroke, now come to the compression stroke, air induced during the suction stroke is compressed into the clearance volume, both valve remains will closed. Then expansion stroke, fuel injection starts nearly at the end of compression stroke. When piston will move upward, the fuel will start to inject. The rate of injection is such that the combustion maintains the pressure constant in spite of piston movement, because we will inject fuel, but we will inject fuel in such a way that when the piston will move downward, in spite of injection of fuel, the pressure within the cylinder will remain constant. So fuel addition at constant pressure. Heat is assumed to have been added at constant pressure. So this point is to be noted. During the heat addition is at constant pressure. The pressure within the cylinder remains constant. Piston will move downward. The pressure within the cylinder remains constant. After injection of fuel is completed, the products of combustion expand. Both valves remain closed. After injection of fuel, this valve will remain closed and the piston will start to move downward. The next stroke is exhaust stroke. In exhaust stroke, the piston traveling from bottom dead center to top dead center pushes out the products of combustion. The exhaust valve is open and the intake valve is closed during this stroke. So these compression ignition engine is explained on PV and TS diagram. We will discuss pressure, volume and temperature entropy diagram. So first we will start with the pressure volume diagram. There are total four parameters we are discussing here. One is pressure, second is volume, third is temperature, and fourth is entropy. Why we need to discuss these four parameters? For the calculation purposes and to get the work output of the engine. We will discuss in coming lectures. So we'll start with the PV diagram. So in PV diagram, what we have? First, we have this 6-to-1 process. We have this 6-to-1 process. It is constant pressure intake of air at P0. Pressure is P0. P0 is atmospheric pressure. So this is constant pressure intake. 6-to-1 is constant pressure. Piston will move downward. The air will come, and we assume that air will come at fixed pressure. We are assuming idle conditions. So from 6-to-1, constant pressure air intake. So what will be happening from 6-to-1? Volume is increasing. At 6, what is volume? At 6 point, volume is VC. So volume will increase from VC to VT. So volume increasing from 6-to-1. Now come to the 1-to-2 process. This 1-to-2 process is isentropic compression stroke. 1-to-2, this is isentropic. This 1-to-2, this is isentropic process. As you can see in TS diagram, 1-to-2, entropy is constant. Entropy is constant, temperature will increase. You can see here on TS diagram, 1-to-2 process, entropy is constant, temperature will increase. On PV diagram, you can say 1 to 2, volume will decrease, pressure will increase. Volume is decreasing from 1 to 2 because it is a compression stroke. Because it is a compression. Jab bhi aap compress karoge, whenever you compress something, volume will decrease. So volume is decreasing from 1 to 2. Volume is decreasing from 1 to 2. Pressure is increasing from 1 to 2. So this is isentropic compression. Now come to the next process. That is 2 to 3. 2 to 3. 2 to 3. So what is happening from 2 to 3? 2 to 3 is constant pressure heat input. So in 2 to 3, we are adding heat. We are adding heat from 2 to 3. Pressure is constant. You can see here pressure is constant. P3 is equal to P2. Pressure is constant. Pressure is constant. Temperature increase. Whenever you add heat, temperature is increasing from T2 to T3. Temperature is increasing. Entropy will increase. Entropy also increasing. Temperature also increasing. So this is constant pressure heat addition. Next process is 3 to 4. This 3 to 4. 3 to 4 is isentropic power or expansion stroke. This 3 to 4 is isentropic power or expansion stroke. Isentropic power or expansion stroke. From 3 to 4, your entropy is same. From 3 to 4, entropy is same. Temperature will decrease. Because when your piston will move downward, what will happen? When your piston moves down, expansion will take place. Okay, temperature will decrease. Entropy remains constant. Here from 3 to 4, you can see from 3 to 4, what is happening? Your volume will increase, expansion, because it is expansion. 3 to 4, volume will increase. Pressure will decrease. Temperature will decrease. And entropy will remain constant. Then 4 to 5. This is 4 to 5 process. 4, 2, this 5. Okay. What is happening from 4 to 5? This is constant volume heat rejection. So 4 to 5 is heat rejection. So 4 to, you can say here 4 to 5. This is 4 to 5. This is 4 to 5. This is constant volume heat rejection. Blow down. Exhaust valve open and intake valve close. So what will happen? When the exhaust valve will open, so gases will blow out automatically. Gases will blow out automatically without the movement of piston. You can see from 4 to 5, volume is constant. It means, at what is the volume? Vt. From 4 to 5, volume is Vt. So it means piston is at this position. Piston is at this position. Whenever you will open this valve, the gases will automatically go out without the movement of piston. Because gases are at a higher pressure. So they will automatically go out of the, you can say, this combustion chamber. When you open this valve, these gases will go automatically out. So this is your exhaust blowdown. So 4 to 5 is exhaust blowdown process. Next is your 5 to 6. 5 to 6. 5 to 6. This process 5 to 6 in this direction. If you see in this direction, from 5 to 6. 5 to 6. So this is your constant pressure exhaust stroke. So your piston will move up. Piston will move up. Okay. When your piston will move up, okay, so what will happen? We are taking idle conditions. We are taking idle condition that pressure remains constant. Piston will just move up. It will just remove the residual gases within the cylinder. Within the cylinder, what is pressure? When your piston move up, what is pressure? It is atmospheric. Because when you had opened this valve, gases had gone out automatically due to high pressure. So now whatever the residuals, you can say gases here at atmosphere pressure, that we have to remove. Because in the next cycle, we have to take fresh charge. So we have to remove the gases which are at atmosphere pressures, burned gases, which are not useful for us. We have to remove those gases out of the cylinder. So piston will move up, the pressure is constant, and the gases will go out of the cylinder. So this process is denoted here from 1 to 6 in this direction. Not 1 to 6, from 5 to 6. 5 to 6. 5 to 6. You can see here, what is 5 to 6? Volume will decrease. volume will decrease from VT to VC. Pressure remains constant because we have to just move the piston up and we have to remove the gases which are atmosphere pressure in the combustion chamber. We have to remove those gases. Okay, so this is the complete, you can say complete four stroke CI engine working. Pressure volume diagram and TS diagram. Okay, next we come up with the two stroke spark ignition engine.